For more information on SPS1 and the Success Community, visit SurvivorPhilippinesSucks.yuku.com. It's a Flame Fest 8 years in the making, and it's about to get ugly. Hey everybody, I'm Midway Haven, your guide to what sucks in Survivor Philippines, and this is the pilot preseason roundup of SPS1. Tinatalang 15,000 katao ang pumila ng katagal-tagal sa kung saan-saang SM Mall sa Dagupan, Cebu, Baguio, Davao at Manila para makipag 5-minute blind date sa mga screener na bading ng Survivor Philippines. Siyempre, hindi lahat ng 15,000 na yan sinaswerteng makasama si Paolo. Nothing's for sure, but as of mid-June, the 16 so-called castaways are probably already slumming it out in some white sand beach in Thailand. Oh yes, bitches, we all know it's in Thailand. You can't keep a secret from us for that long. As of June 15, both Survivor Philippines Sucks and SurvivorPhilippines.com have confirmed the identities of at least 9 of the contestants. This, of course, serves as a wake-up call to GMA to fire your secret keepers because, sadly, it ain't working so good. Oh, ito pa. Akala nyo ba lahat ng 16 na yung mga ordinary na Pinoy? Wrong! If you're new to Survivor Sucks, well, hello and welcome. Let me introduce to you the Mactor! Okay, class, listen up. The word Mactor is a combination of two different words, model and actor. A Mactor may look like a person, eat like a person, and even dress like a person, but the fact is, they're not human. Mga alien po sila. Sila'y matatangkad, maputi ang balat, and generally hot and good looking.
But their only goal is to complete an utter invasion of Earth through the use of their awesome powers of camera whoring.
At ayon sa aming sources, halos lahat po ng nasa Survivor Philippines ngayon ay Mactors. Anong ina-expect niyo ba ding ang pumili sa screening eh? Of course, every reality show in the world today has Mactors. GMA TV, in their quest to devour foreign franchises, is on a rabid quest to get that Mactor factor, so to speak, to make Survivor more interesting to the locals. I doubt this is gonna work though. I mean, the way that GMA is running their other franchise. What's more, Survivor Philippines is gonna be shown daily. Parang extra challenge, pero wala si RFL. Now, you can watch your favorite media horse every night, alongside such upcoming shows like Kim Sang-soon and that robot Spider Boy freak thingy. Well, if there's one thing GMA is keeping secret, it's the premiere itself. We'll just have to keep our seething love for their Mactors until then. For now, this is Midway Haven saying if it's on Survivor, then it definitely sucks.